The sad thing about our country is that we pay too much lip service to corporate social responsibility. It does not exist. It's a new fraud, and we're talking about change in this country. If we have to stop corruption, we need to look beyond politicians and public servants. Yeah. We need to look at the corporate fraud going on in this country. He spoke about the amount of money that even companies, South African companies in Nigeria, are spending for wheelchair basketball and special sports in South Africa. Yeah. I can tell you that wheelchair basketball gets $1 million from a telecommunication company that exists in Nigeria. I've challenged them once on channels. Look at what Channels TV is doing for us. That is corporate social responsibility, not the fraud that we see everywhere. Go and check the budgets of banks, of telecommunication companies. You see the amount of money they spend on social corporate social responsibility. On who? It's a fraud.
Well, I think let's go back to basketball. I get your point. I understand how painful it can be.
To answer your question, I am very optimistic that we'll only grow from where we are beyond the comprehension of anybody. Who would have expected that we'll still be existing today? Mm-hmm. 4 years after, we have more than 16 foreign-based. We have two in America. You know of the story of Richard, who got involved in an accident. Mm-hmm. Today is a professional player in America. Lucky was a cameraman in our first edition.
Definitely, sir.
Did not know anything about wheelchair basketball. He's in New Jersey now playing professional basketball. Musiba Shitu.
Yeah.
Yes. And Ahmed.
And Saeed.
And what's the girl? The Imo State girl.
Eno.
They went to a competition in Germany in April, and they all got stolen. They can't play for Nigeria because of their papers. They cannot come for this competition. But guess what? This competition has churned out some wonderful talents that are going to represent us in Algeria.
We bless God for that. I just want you to
we feel there's light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah. Oh.
Fantastic. You know, we're trying to talk about, you know, having a league, you know, having a professional league, like you have the MBBF, you know, having a league that week in, week out, you know, they have a season and all that.
They do in South Africa.
I talked about it before you guys came on the show. Can we have something like that in Nigeria? How possible is it?
It was part of our, we had it in the blueprint.
Definitely.
But my sister, I just told you the fraud going on in this country. How are we going to do that? We in the last 4.5 years, Victor Oche and his friends have raised and supported us with over 200 million naira. We've collected only 10 million from the NSC.
Bringing NSC into it now. Yeah. Is it not possible for, you know, the association to work with NSC to have a league?
What are they doing?
Because
if you're having
a competition every year, this is the only competition every year, right? We don't have more than this, except when the players go outside and all that. Then scouts come, they usually come in, then they pick them and they get to play. Now, what if this federation and, of course, NSC work together and have a league for those who are really interested?
Because you
have to wait for this competition for you to participate in it.
You know, I feel very sad for the NSC, seriously. But I'm also grateful to God that we have someone like Yakmut Alhazan as a DG now. The DJ before Yakmut Alhazan was my friend and brother. He paid lip service to sport development. You know, but look at what Yakmut Alhazan did yesterday to hockey. Hockey was a forgotten sport.
Yeah. Yes.
But look at what he's been doing. The other day he came to Lagos, he visited, but the man's hands are tied. Yeah. How much does he have in his portfolio to support every sport? Yeah. It is not his responsibility.
So the budget should be increased so that they can...
No, I don't believe, even as a commissioner, I never believed in getting money from government coffers.
You're result-oriented.
Everything we did as a commissioner, everything we did, my team and I did in Ogun State, was to go back to the public and go back to my friends who are very wealthy. But just as I'm doing now with wheelchair basketball, I have a senator who gave us $1 million. I want to thank the governor of Lagos State, both the present and the past. Governor Fashola and I bumped into each other on the flight from South Africa to Nigeria. And when he saw me, he greeted me in his usual way. Ah, Bukola, I said, Egbon, I'm not happy. He said, what? I said, Egbon, I need 15 million between now and next week to take my team. Was it South Africa or Angola?
Angola.
And he called Enito Oshodi. By the following, Enito was getting angry. He was angry with me. Why didn't he tell me? I said, your guy's my Egbon. I can tell him anything I want to tell him. Got the money.
I like that. But let's get...
Governor Akinwumi Ambode. Maybe a little over 1 month in office has started supporting us.
We just hope that more persons
come. We can only encourage more people
get
to come in.
Respond briefly to this. The Eighth Nation qualifiers in Algiers, really important for Team Nigeria. How confident that, are you that we can go there and pick a ticket?
Yeah, I'm always confident. You know, even my president always said, Dope, you are always overconfident. I've played wheelchair basketball for over 15 to 20 years now.
Wow.
The thing is, a game is a game. It was whoever turn up of the day wins the game. That is my own philosophy. And the thing is, I can't say, okay, I'm going to the commission to go and lose to anybody. I can only go there and do the best that I can. Mm. But the thing is, there's always going to be a winner. Mm. And I count myself and my team as one of the winner. So going to this competition, by God's grace, there's a chance for everybody to win the championship.
Yeah.
We have talent right here in Nigeria. I tell you, when I came back, even there's a lot of things that I have seen that I'm just, you know, blown away. And as I said, you know, with the help of our guy here, he's been going everywhere to make sure things are okay for us. And Coach Adeoke, Prince Adeyemi, the Director General of Lagos State, the Governor Ambode government, the Deputy Governor, you know, everybody's just been supportive. Yesterday we received 8 good basketball chairs from Lagos State.
I was going to go there because I was watching it. I was looking at most of the wheelchair the way they use it. That it's not really the one I see most times when I watch international competition.
What's the difference? I heard what you said. But you were wrong. You've not followed us well. 2 years ago, we bought almost 15 world class. We still have more coming from ROGK.
Okay.
Honorable Victor Oche, from his pocket, bought orders for the national team. But it was during my challenge to Governor Fashola that Eniton Oshodi purchased those for Lagos State.
Okay. Recently. Okay, what about other states that came?
Look, you'll be shocked. But let me tell you something, I won't mention names of states. We should start pointing at wrongdoings.
Yeah.
I called Director Generals. Okay, I called the Director General to shame him. He's my friend. And I told him I was going to call his governor that you sent your team, a state that is renowned for sports, you sent your team to Lagos without a dime. Eventually, he sent 150,000. Last year, I called the Commissioner for Sports. This, I will mention his name. I called the Commissioner for Sports, Ogun State, because it's my state. And he's my successor. I'm the predecessor there. Victor Oche called him too as a personal friend. He's a senator today. He promised to do something. He gave those boys 50,000. The money we give them as subsidy is more than that.
That's not fair.
People pay lip service to development. You're talking about development of wheelchair basketball and special sport. If you really want to help us, like you've always done, Austin.
Yeah.
We need to start hitting the nail on the head.
We will. Okay. We will. It will get better. And that's what Olayinka Yusuf is doing on Twitter. He says, in order to promote participation in wheelchair basketball, camps should be organized in states. Chairs and kits should also be provided. And Balogun Vera Okoro says, the Federation should provide electric wheelchairs for them. It's much more hard work wheeling with both hands and trying to catch the ball.
So can I say something about that? You can't play basketball with electric wheelchairs. That's everybody. You know, it's so obvious. Like you use your hand to push the chair, and that's what is required. You know, at any level in wheelchair basketball. Mm. So, you know, thank those who send in their their opinion about the whole thing.
Well, we can only hope that things will definitely get better. And
we pray.
Sure. But you know, kudos to you guys for the fantastic job you're doing. We're really proud.
Please, can I say something?
Okay, please do.
Yeah. Number one, I just want to give my appreciation, to those who's been supporting us.
Mm. Okay.
As I mentioned, Governor Ambode, you've been fantastic. If you've been watching, I want to say thank you.
All right.
The Deputy Governor, because it is hard. You know, for disabled people in this country, in Nigeria that we're living. I will tell you, some people don't eat before they come to training. But it is the passion that they have for this sport. Everybody wants to represent their country. I'll tell you one thing. In year 2006-2007, I was drafted into Australian national team. Then I was still playing in London. And I spoke to one of my mentors. I said, you know what? Now I've You know, because everybody wants to be popular, everybody wants to have, everyone wants to have money. And I know if I play for Australia, I will have all that. Mm. And I spoke to one of my mentors in the UK and said, you know what, I've been drafted to Australia national team. And he called me and said, Peter, you're from Nigeria? I said, yes. He said, it is better to be, you know, to be a big fish in a small pond than to be a small fish in a big pond. And I don't understand, you know, what he was saying then. Later, I went back to Australia. I was talking to a friend of mine. I said, somebody, one of my mentors said this. He said, if you play for Australia, you're going to play for probably a period of 5 years. And probably after that, you're going to be forgotten. And but if you go to Nigeria and develop wheelchair basketball with your people over there, one day, you know, these people, you change so many lives.
And you'll be celebrated.
You're living a legacy.
And, and a legacy. I really thank God that when our president now, you know, coming, I was, came in into the association, because I've heard a lot about him before he came in. And I was, you know, because I'm sorry to say this, because when you meet rich people in Nigeria, everybody think, okay, because you're on wheelchair, you're coming to beg for money. And that is the perspective we are trying to change.
Okay.
We are not born to be a beggar. It's only the circumstance that we find ourselves in. I always tell people that, you know what, we can't change what we are by nature, but by choice, we can change it. And you see a lot of people beg. Now everybody has been thinking, okay, I don't need to beg anymore if there's a way out of this situation. So that's why I said I want to, you know, again, Oga, thank you very much.
Thank you, man.
We're so delighted, thank really. You to the we are so delighted. Of,
you know, Lagos State Sports Council, the deputy governor, and my prince is downstairs.
He's only can the States.
Yeah,
I have to be
I think the message. I think the message really, really has gone
Victor,
home.
Victor,
it's clear.
Victor Oji has been the father of disabled. As far as I'm concerned, he's the father of disabled in Nigeria. And I hope, you know, it will continue.
All right.
And I pray it will continue.
Thank you so much for spending time with us on the show.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well, guys,
finals
I don't know.
Is definitely on Saturday, so we'll be there to watch.
We are appealing to the public. Come and watch.
You can just come and watch.
It's going to be exciting that the Shoki is committed to come and play. One other young superstar is committed to come and play. Okay. So we're looking at it. Very exciting. What we do with wheelchair basketball, we mix it with entertainment.
All right.
That's our finals are always awesome.
So that's your own way you can contribute to the development of wheelchair basketball. Make some time to be at the finals on Saturday. The venue, let them know.
National Stadium.
National Stadium.
At the time, of course.
Starts from 12.
12 now. All right. I don't know. Can we still do this? Because we're really running out of time
definitely.
Now.
I think if we can just, before they leave the stage, I mean, we can just, Joseph Mourinho actually talked about the fact that he's actually in trouble right now with the FA. And of course, he made some reactions. Let's just get to listen to him.